Welcome back, folks. In this movie, I'm going to talk about smart filters. So this is really a very, very nice goodies if you are using smart object. Because if you are using smart object and you apply any filter to them, actually it will going to make another layer and it will directly link to that. So if you want to unchange it, you can just go ahead, hide that smart filters, you can turn off and it will going to automatically turn off. And this is really, really very nice goodies. So let me show you what I mean. So here you can see this is smart object I just created, and here you can see this is the same image, but this is not smart object, you can say, because there is a no smart object icon indication here, so that's why it's not a smart object, but this is smart object. So let me show you a good thing. So this is a smart object. Now I'm going to apply a filter. I go to filter, and here I can use any filter and apply it. Well, I'm going to stylize, and here I apply which one? Actually tiles is really nice, so let's apply tiles. So actually number of tiles, so what number of tiles you want? 5, 2, 3, 4, whatever. So let me show you. Okay, fine, 5 is enough. And now I just go ahead and click OK, and now I can see this is a 5 tiles comes in. This is a single filter. And even the best thing about smart filters is that if you don't need these tiles, you can just go ahead and turn it off, and you can see this is your original image, it's already preserved. And this is really, really nice thing. I mean, you can just go ahead, turn it on or turn it off, it's totally up to you. Even what you can do, you can just go ahead, double click on this one, and you can change it. I mean, I need a 10 number of tiles, and go ahead, okay, and now you can see it's the 10 number of tiles. This is really amazing. So if I apply here, you can see this is not a smart object. I go to filter, I go to stylize, and here I apply tiles, and let's, and I keep number of tiles 10, and I hit okay, and you can see this is applied, but you can see there's a nothing is there that I can turn it off. I mean, there's nothing, any option out there, so I can change it. I mean, this is really, really bad. So this is the power of smart object and smart filters. Well, get rid of this one because we don't need. I just wanted to show you a single example, and now you understand. So now what you can do? Well, you can do a lot of things. I mean, you can stack filters. Let me show you. You can see this is a one filter is already applied here. I go to filter once again, and I go to stylize, and here what I do, I can just solarize it. And now what I can do, you can see this is solarize, this looks really, really nice. I mean, you can see this is really cool. But you say, no, I don't need this style. Well, you know that you can just go ahead, turn it off, and I can see how it's look in solarize view, and this is really looks very nice. So what you can do, well, you can apply another one. Let me show you. I go to filter and stylize, and even I can apply wine filter, that is make a little bit of wine. You can see this, I mean, just go ahead, hit, and you can see this is look like some wine. So if you want, then go ahead and do that. Well, if you want, then double click on this one, and you can still edit it. You can see wine, you can need a blast or stazer, whatever. You can see, you can see here preview, so you can just minimize it to see it full, and you can see how it's gonna look like. I mean, you can just use stazer. You can see this is really, really nice. So you can see you can like blast, and now hit okay, and now you can see how it's look like. That's really cool. I mean, you can stack your filters, and even you can turn it off or on, it's totally up to you. So let's apply more filters. That's really look cool. Okay, so go to filter, and here when you can see this time I go to blur, and you can see because this is running, I'm going to apply motion blur. So it will going to make it in a motion, so you can see it's create a motion. And if you want, then you can just decrease it, hit okay, you can see it clearly. But you know that what you can do, you can just go ahead, turn this wine filter off, and you can see that's gonna be motions. And you can even turn off solarize, and now you can see how it's looking at my emotions. And even there's the best thing that you can just go ahead and just turn it off, and even turn motion blur off. Go to filter, and here you can see go to blur, and you apply the surface blur. And now here's the best thing you can do with that. Let me show you. You can just go ahead, apply this surface blur, and this is going to make it so, so transparent, so nice. And you can just skip select this one, and now you will get so much power. I mean, you can see this surface blur, you can just go ahead and change its mode. Let me show you. If I double click this one, and now you can change its mode to surface blur. You can see this is a mode, and you can just go ahead, change it whatever you want. You can make it lighten or make it a difference, whatever you want, it's totally up to you. We can even change its opacity. I mean, this much power you will get by using smart filters, and that's really amazing. And even you will get more than that. Let me show you what I mean. So you can see I just selected this one, and I hit B in my keyboard, and even I take a brush tool from here, it's really up to me. And I paint black here, so now you can see if I just paint black here, you can see, I mean, you're going to make it so much difference. You just taking that blur traveler away, and that's really, really cool. I mean, you can see, I mean, this is so nice, and you can see this is actually painting white out there. So what I do, I press Control Z, and let me turn this off, this solarize effect, so it will going to see very clearly that what is going to happen in behind the scenes. So I just go ahead, turn this motion blur on, and now you will see it clearly what's going to happen. So now what I do, I just go ahead, select the smart filters, and you can see this brush tool is already selected, and I paint black here. You can see now you will see it clearly, and you can see it's actually taking this filter away, and that's really, really cool. You can see this, I mean, this is so amazing, and this is so much powerful, and this is the power of smart object and smart filters. So I highly recommend, go ahead and use these smart filters in your daily Photoshop life. This is going to make your life so much easier and so much powerful. So go ahead and use it, enjoy it, and thank you so much. See you in the next movie.